Hi, I'm Dr. Shree Rao. I'm an ENT surgeon specialized in hearing restoration and cochlear implant surgeries. Today, I'll be addressing the frequently asked questions regarding a cochlear implant and its surgical procedure. What is a cochlear implant? A cochlear implant is a small but a powerful neuroprosthetic device which is surgically implanted into your inner ear that produces sound signals directly into your hearing nerve. What this means is that this cochlear implant provides a perception of sound for the people who are completely born deaf or the people who have lost hearing at a later stage in life and make them to hear well, normal, like us. Unlike the hearing aids, which just amplify the sounds like a loudspeaker, this cochlear implant, it bypasses all the damaged parts of your inner ear and directly stimulates your hearing nerve. So it's more or less like communicating directly with the auditory system part of your brain. How is a hearing aid different from a cochlear implant? Both the hearing aids and cochlear implants are useful for people who have hearing loss and they make them to hear well. But there are some major differences between these hearing aids and the cochlear implants. Let me explain you. The hearing aids are useful for people who have somewhere around mild to moderate or a bit of severe hearing loss. That is between 40 to 70 decibels or 75 decibels of hearing loss. But they're not useful when they have around 90 decibels hearing loss. We call this as profound hearing loss. Whereas this cochlear implant work best when the people have profound hearing loss, that is around 90 decibels hearing loss, where the hearing aids cannot help at all. So this is one of the major difference between these two. Coming to the functional part, the hearing aid just functions like a loudspeaker. It just amplifies the sound. Whereas the cochlear implant, it produces electrical signals directly into the hearing nerve by bypassing all the damaged parts of your inner ear. Thus, the perception of sound and the quality of speech what you get is much more superior than what you get with a hearing aid. Coming to the second major difference between a hearing aid and cochlear implant is that a hearing aid does not require any surgical procedure to use. It's just like the glasses what you wear for your diminished vision. Once you put on the hearing aid, that's it, you're good to use. Whereas a cochlear implant, it requires a proper surgical procedure to get the cochlear implant surgically implanted into your inner ear. And it takes around 6 months to 1 year for you to get adapted to these new sounds. So if your loud ones have somewhere around moderate to severe hearing loss, you can go ahead with the hearing aids. But if they're not getting benefited with the hearing aids, if their speech perception is not good with the hearing aids, then they have somewhere around profound hearing loss, cochlear implant is the best option for them. Is cochlear implant surgery a major surgery? Many people who are suffering with profound hearing loss or people who are not at all benefiting with the hearing aids are just still worried about the surgical component which is involved in the cochlear implant surgery. Let me put it this way. A typical cochlear implant surgery takes around 2 hours of time and it'll be done under general anesthesia. That is, you experience no pain during the surgical procedure at all. Coming to the surgical part, a small cut will be made behind the ear and the receiver stimulator or the internal component will be surgically implanted into the skull and the electrodes whichever are present are threaded into your inner ear or the cochlea. Once again, the wound is closed in layers and the working status of this implant is checked in the OT itself, in the operation theater itself. It takes around 3 to 4 weeks for this entire wound to heal. And finally, we activate this implant with an external processor. That's it. It's done. As simple as that. When a proper preoperative evaluation is done and a very good intraoperative care is taken during the surgical procedure, maintaining strict aseptic precautions during the procedure, and a good postoperative care is taken by the patient, this cochlear implant surgery is a fairly well-tolerated and a safe surgery. Do cochlear implants sound like normal? Well, when I asked this question to a 6-year or 7-year-old child who is completely born deaf who has been implanted at an age of 1 or 2 years old with a cochlear implant. He would say that, "I'm able to hear absolutely normal, that's why I'm able to speak just like you, and I'm able to go to a normal school, just like my friends." But when I asked this same question to an adult who had absolutely normal hearing like us, but lost his hearing due to various reasons like meningitis or some viral infections, or because of reaction to other certain medications, he would say that the cochlear implant sounds a bit electronic or robotic, and some even say that I can hear a Mickey Mouse speaking. But the same person, when he attends regular mapping sessions, audioverbal therapy religiously, he would say that I'm able to enjoy my hearing. I'm able to hear normally, in fact, infinitely better than not having hearing at all. And this is what they say. Do you sleep with a cochlear implant? Well, I would say you'll be sleeping with half of your cochlear implant. As said earlier, a cochlear implant has two parts, an external component and an internal component. The external component needs to be removed every day before you go to sleep, because this has to be placed in a separate box in order to remove the moisture from the speech processor, and of course to recharge the battery of the speech processor also. But the internal component, which has been surgically implanted during the surgery, need not be removed. It'll be staying with you throughout your life. How does a cochlear implant work? A cochlear implant basically consists of two components, an external component and an internal component. An external component has a microphone and a speech processor, and it just looks like a hearing aid and will be worn like a hearing aid behind the ear. But of course, there are recent advances where this external component in the form of hearing aid is being replaced by just a carom coin. The entire components, the speech processor and the microphone, are just embedded inside this, and this will just be hidden inside your hair. So the sound signals from the surroundings are received by this microphone, and they are sent to the speech processor. And this speech processor is just like a mini computer. This mini computer, it analyzes the sound signals and transforms them into electrical impulses. And from the external component, these electrical impulses are sent through a magnet to the internal component. This way, this internal component will be surgically implanted by a surgeon into your inner ear. This internal component has further two parts, a receiver stimulator and an electrode array. This receiver stimulator will be surgically implanted just beneath the scalp and behind the ear. And the electrodes, whichever are present, are threaded into the cochlea. So the electrical impulses, which are transferred from the mini computer or the speech processor, are received by the receiver stimulator, and from there they are further sent to the electrodes, which are threaded into the cochlea. These electrodes, they directly stimulate your hearing nerve, and from there these electrical signals from the auditory nerve are sent to the brain, and the brain perceives them as sound, and this is how you understand speech with a cochlear implant. Who is suitable for a cochlear implantation? A cochlear implant is suitable for people with severe to profound hearing loss. That is, people who have hearing loss of more than 70 decibels hearing loss. And also people who do not benefit or who do not understand speech even after using a good fitted hearing aids. So, the children who are born deaf, or children who are deafened at a young age, or even adults who have become deaf or whose hearing has worsened to a point where hearing aids are no longer beneficial for them, are generally considered as ideal candidates for cochlear implantation. A cochlear implant team will help decide if cochlear implants are a good option for you or not. A cochlear implant team includes an ENT surgeon who has specialized in cochlear implant surgery, an audiologist, and an AVT specialist. If you are considering a cochlear implant, your audiologist will perform a couple of tests called pure tone audiometry, impedance audiometry, OAE, Vera, and certain further assessments in order to determine whether you can benefit from a cochlear implant or not. Later, you'll be thoroughly evaluated by a cochlear implant surgeon in the form of medical scans. And if you're medically fit, we'll be proceeding with a cochlear implant surgery. Hope you liked this video. If your friends or your family members are suffering with hearing loss or any of the difficulties which I mentioned earlier in this video, please do share this video so that it could be helpful for them. Thank you.